Hey, it's Eric here. Let's go ahead and talk about the more advanced movement techniques in Scratch. I'm going to go ahead and assume you have a basic understanding of the fundamental movement blocks in Scratch, such as move, turn, point and direction, go to, change and set. But let's talk about the more complex blocks we can work with. Let's start with the point towards block. Now I want you to think of this as the point and direction block, but instead of assigning a value, we're going to assign an object or something for it to look towards. So for instance, point towards. We have, at the moment, one option, but in the future, when you're creating more dynamic projects with more than one object, you may have an object in there. So right now, we only have a mouse pointer, so we'll click that. Now, if all goes according to plan, our sprite should point towards our mouse pointer, which is our cursor. So let's go ahead and try it out. Voila, there you go. So you see our sprite is staring at where my mouse pointer was when I started the program. And unfortunately, it's not updating, which I would like to see it update the direction. So as I move my mouse cursor, I would like to see the sprite move as well. And to do this, we'll need to introduce the concept of a loop, so a forever loop. And what this will do is I want to put my point towards block in this loop and say always forever be updating this point towards to my mouse pointer. So when I click the green flag, the sprite will always be looking at this mouse pointer, which is pretty cool. It's kind of creepy, actually, because it's going to keep looking at me. And anyway, so we'll go back to our motion. Actually, I'm going to stop this so it stops looking at me. I'm going to go back, and we'll introduce this concept of set rotation style. This is here at the bottom. And we see it says set rotation style left to right. So you notice when I started my program, we could see that our sprite turned upside down. But say we don't want that. Say this is a person walking and we want him or her to never be on their head. So we'll go ahead and set the rotation style left to right, drag it in our forever loop, and we'll see that when I go to the left, it will take the direction of the mouse pointer, but it will never show the sprite going upside down. Likewise, when I go to the right, it won't go upside down. So it understands the movement, but it sort of limits it. So you never have, you know, someone doing a headstand or something like that. And actually, we have a number of different options to choose from in the rotation style. So we have the left and the right. We also have an option to say never rotate. So this will ignore any rotation information. And we have an all around, which is actually the default that we had before, which is pointing in any direction available. So not just left and right, but upside down, sideways, you name it. So let's go ahead and introduce another pretty dynamic block. So we'll go ahead, delete these two. And we'll introduce the go to block. And this is similar to the go to XY block. But in this case, we're going to assign it to go to an object. In this case, we only have to choose from a mouse pointer. So it's going to say go to mouse pointer. And you can see I accidentally clicked it and it kind of previewed what this is going to do. And that means go to the mouse pointer. So we'll go ahead, click it, and drag it into our forever loop. And we'll say go to mouse pointer. So you can see it updates and our object will follow wherever that mouse pointer is. So at this point, we've covered pretty much all the blocks except for this last one, which is the if on edge bounce. Now, this is so fun. I love this block because it enables you to create scenes that are dynamic because our sprite can start bouncing off of things. So I'll go ahead, I'll delete the mouse pointer block, and we'll create some motion here. So we'll create a move block here, and we're going to say for our sprite, we want them to forever move 10 steps. So what does this look like? Let's give it a shot. So we'll hit the green flag, and there you go. So what if, wouldn't it be cool if we have enabled the sprite to bounce off a corner? So instead of getting stuck, it's going to bounce, and we have that, and that's the if on edge bounce block. We'll go ahead. Program's still running. I'll go ahead and drop this in. And as we can see, pretty cool. Our sprite is now bouncing off any edge it gets, it's going to bounce. Really dynamic block, fun to have in any project. So I'll go ahead and say I want to speed this up. Here's another sort of advanced movement technique. If you put some of these movement blocks in the forever loop, these actually take on sort of like a speed, if you will. So right now I have it at move 10 steps. Say I want to speed it up just a little bit. I can now say forever move 30 steps. And you can see it speeds up. And additionally, I'm going to slow it down right now to about 20. But additionally, we have the turn can take the same command. So forever turn 15 degrees. So we'll go ahead and drop this, and you'll see that, you know, now we have our sprite spins at 15 degrees, so it takes on more of a rotation, a speed. Again, I could speed it up and say now move 50. So now it goes faster, and likewise, I can make it a little bit slower, like at one. So, you know, keep this in mind. When you're in a loop, motion sort of takes on a whole new dynamic.